Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Days After on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Days After and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Days After. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to get started we need to open our main web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL that I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type the URL, because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up here on our site of Usitility, where we find here a precise explanation on how you can download and install Days After on PC. We search down a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on the link, we land here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Days After on PC. As you can discover here we have a number of advantages of running this emulator. So we will proceed to download the Days After by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the browser to see the installation software much better. The installation software is very simple. It consists of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We basically simply click on it. And therefore we see that we have here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we choose to change this directory we have got to click on the browse button, and we select another directory and set up the emulator where we desire. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I click on install. Fantastic, the installation starts and it is going to proceed in the download of those megabytes that are represented on the screen. Once you download it, it could possibly be a bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, based on your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Right now they're progressing extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can discover, down here, there is a progress bar which will fill up and once it attains the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. Indeed the emulator has already been launched there for the first time. Before we keep going, as you can discover, it has created a couple of icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the only one we are interested in. Anytime we choose to operate Days After on the PC, we double-click on this specific app icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we do the next step, which is actually a must, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we are going to click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is launched. Here we are required to sign in. Presently when we are on this page, we must execute the next step which is imperative. So we click on Sign In. Presently it says, Checking Info. It can once in a while get stuck in checking info, that's why it doesn't move ahead. In this case, you can try to connect to your account after a few hours it's going to most likely be repaired. At this time we are going to enter our username and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For example you can use the same email you use at the moment in your YouTube account. Therefore I am going to type my details and I will come back after I have accomplished it. Voila, data entered. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We will agree to them all by clicking on I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected and it'll produce a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched by default and completely on its own. To install the application, we must go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon marked in green. At present that we are on the desktop of the emulator for Android, we see that we find right here the install video game button. We then click on the button. Listed here we have the game. Let's click now on the install option that I'm displaying now in green color. That click will start the installation. straight away it will install the game. It usually takes quite some time, or it could be very fast. This all relies on the internet connection. It has already completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this option that I am emphasizing in green, so that you can launch days after for the first time. You are by now on the emulator desktop, and we are going to just click that new days after icon that was created. Your game is launched for the very first time. There we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the volume of that emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is the first one. We then click on this app icon that I am mentioning in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, having one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case that we desire to enjoy the application in full screen, we click this particular app icon. And as a consequence we would already be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To leave the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And thus we would already play in normal display screen mode. At present, I am going to show you the computer keys mapping, which is certainly quite appealing. This strategy we will be able to use the video game much more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this app icon. And at this time there you will be able to make the recommended configurations. I'll go ahead and keep the default configuration, though if you want to change it, you can also do it now with no problem. As you can observe, the emulator is completely in our language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is started in the wrong language, as an example, in Japanese. And thus to set it in the right language we go there to the cogwheel. And thus here within many other settings, we just click the language drop down. We should decide on the language we like, Italian, Chinese, etc. Once the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will restart, along with the game, next time we use it, would also be in the specified language. So now, there is another detail that we have to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email indicating that a completely new device has been connected to our Google account. It is going to question us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Absolutely, we may not get worried, because the emulator is acting as an Google Android smartphone or tablet. So you can see which device is currently being emulated. We come right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Let's go here to the model option. And now we see that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for the video user demo. I hope you appreciated it, particularly that you found it informative. If so, give it a good like, subscribe, and any comments, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment area below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Check out any of these video tutorials that happens to be appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the future video game videos. Bye.